Hello and welcome to the first edition of the quarantine COVID-19 coronavirus outbreak of the year 2020. So I'm prefacing this video for future Andy and Tommy as you guys get older of what it's like when the world suddenly stops and there's no more school to go to, no more bars or restaurants to go to. Basically, you can't leave your home in some unprecedented virus outbreak. So, as we go through this, I'm kind of recording a little bit each day, kind of logging each day, and I'll do them on little 5-day snippets of what it was like and what we did each day that we were kind of home quarantined and unable to leave. So, without further ado, here's kind of the first 5 days of what it was like, and then I'll follow that at the end of the video with just some news footage just to remember by. So we'll see how it goes. Hopefully we're not stuck here too long with each other. I love you guys, but boy, being home with you every day, whew, it's fun. So
okay, welcome to day one of the coronavirus school cancellation, 3-week stay home quarantine. And we built this pretty awesome marble track. Tom wants us to see it in action. Tom and I did this. Wow. That is great. Probably the best run we've made. Yeah, you're gonna make all of them drop down at one time? Great job. Well, let's see what Andy's doing on his day one quarantine from the coronavirus. Andy, what are you doing?
Can you give me a sheet of cardboard? There's paper in the way. There is? How?
Oh, you're painting. Let's see what you made over here. Oh, that's nice, Andy. Alright, here we are, day two of the school quarantine due to the coronavirus. We're lucky enough to have awesome neighbor, the Benders, who are allowing us to utilize their yard to play in and do whatever. But as you guys watch this back, just know that it's day two and you guys have been really good so far, so thank you. Although there's like another 22 more days to go.
Emily.
And maybe longer, so how good could they really be for that long? This is the COVID-19 home quarantine day number 3. The government has just officially shut down all bars and restaurants last night. So now there truly is nowhere to go. Yes, Andy.
Why did you stay late? Did you know the owner of that bar?
I did. Yeah, I knew him. And so we were talking, me and him and Uncle Tommy.
Why did you stay there? The virus could have gotten you.
It could have, so let's hope it did not. If it does, we'll blame Uncle Donnie. So
and
we're watching.
If it does, we'll blame our daddy for staying up late.
No.
Not telling Uncle Donnie.
No, I was the first one to say hi to Dad.
Yeah, and now we're watching a Great Lakes Science Center live stream because they're closed. So they're doing some curriculum. So we can do at-home experiments every day as part of our learning and curriculum as we have to homeschool our children now. So when you guys watch this back 20 years from now, what a crazy time it is. And the Dow has just dropped 2,500 points and it's just a mess. Okay, Andy and Tommy made their tinfoil boats
just like in the Great Lakes Science Center Curiosity video. Now we're going to float them in our bathtub and see how many bears it takes to sink each boat.
Not infinite. Well, he's not going to go first. We're all going to go.
No? One at a time. All right, Todd is starting to fill up his boat. Well, doing pretty well so far.
We're going to do this again, right?
Yeah. We can make a new style boat with maybe a bigger one. We could do a huge sheet. And we could do a small sheet. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I already passed Dandy's.
I don't know. We'll see. You got to get them all in. Wow, Tom, your boat, I don't think my boat's going to last near as good.
Your edges are small, so it probably isn't.
Yeah, it probably will sink. I think you're right. I think really high edges is the way to go.
Yeah. Tom, your boat is unsinkable, buddy.
Maybe because, no, Tommy still got this car.
I don't think it can hold anymore.
Oh, no! It only sank because the car fell off. Tom, that was awesome, buddy.
Let's ask. Andy, do you think my boat's going to hold up? No?
Yeah.
Tom, do you think my boat's going to hold up?
I'll take the camera.
You'll take the video? Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, here's my boat, and we'll see if it holds up. Wait, I want to put bears in it.
No, we have to do a lot.
Oh. I want some money?
Yeah.
We'll do money and bears. Oh, no. It looks like it's taking on a little water in the front. No. Gosh. Uh-oh. It looks like it's going down. Oh.
I won.
That
was better than I thought, though.
Again.
Okay. Andy's boat version 2. See if it can beat Tom's. So what? Everything in the tub has to go in plus some.
I'm
going to
do the fourth place quarter match.
Boy, this is...
I'm going to do fourth place quarter match.
Oh, no.
Mine won, though, I think.
You think it won?
No, mine did.
I think it could have had a chance to win.
Mine won.
I think there was some self-sabotage.
No, I won. Hey. I got more.
You know who won? Both of you guys won. Because you guys are awesome kids who did a great
science experiment. No, I got more in than Andy.
Is that so?
No, yeah.
Yeah.
Because Andy...
Who do you think won?
Me.
I think it was a tar.
Okay, it's a tar, so we get another round of destruction. We're not using...
Okay, I have made the ultimate indestructible boat. And the children will see if they can... that soap's going to be way heavy.
No, Dad.
I have made the ultimate unsinkable boat. This thing is amazing. I mean, it's not even close to tanking.
Yeah, it is.
Wow, my good. Okay, the only thing that could sink my boat was a Paw Patrol boat. But it's still fighting to come back up. Wow.
That thing's dead.
Sure is. That Paw Patrol boat.
Yeah,
here.
They're playing a game. One to zero.
Slam dunk. 1-1, he scored.
1-1.
Clear, Dad.
Yeah,
they don't mean
anything. Come on. Huh. Oh, you got it. Oh, did you get that block? Yeah.
If you hit the cameraman, it's -1 point. Penalty!
Okay.
Free shot. 3 points.
Right? 3 points.
Hey guys, I'm the cameraman. My name's Andy, and I'm riding my bike.
Okay, Andy, tell me what you did. lunch. You made lunch? What'd you make?
A face.
A with face?
Hair.
The hair? So there's an ice cream bar, there's black raspberries, crackers, a cutie, Mott's and a chocolate piece, and what's to drink?
Green Gatorade.
Green Gatorade. Andy, that was very nice of you to make lunch. You're awesome. Welcome to coronavirus day number 4.
No, day number 3.
No, today's 4. It was Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and today's Tuesday. Today is St. Patrick's Day, so happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody. And we're learning about problems and how to solve them. And so we created a mind map. Andy doesn't want to do homework, so he's trying to create ways to not do homework. And Tom was trying to figure out ways how to feed the fish without him actually doing it. And then we built a leprechaun trap where we have a gold coin of chocolate. And we're going to try and catch a leprechaun today on St. Patty's Day, along with our other usual homeschooling stuff. So,
and which is not standing.
Which is not standing. Should we make the stick shorter?
No.
Is it too long?
Yes.
Okay.
No, how about Dad does it?
It does look like an old ball.
It is still St. Patty's Day, and we're doing an art for kids, Patty. How to draw a leprechaun.
Not
oh, not St. Patty's Day, but St. Patrick's Day?
Other people can call it St. Patty's Day.
Yeah, I agree. Anyways, we love art.
There, they did a green.
I'm going to throw an M&M in my mouth.
Still day 4 of the quarantine. We've adjusted to Lord of the Flies garb as far as what the children wear.
And I'm going to throw in
some are hurt. Some look like Mr. T. And now we're just living off M&Ms. It's been so long.
And I want to get my mouth.
Okay, go ahead.
Oh, and he was blind.
Second try. Oh, that hit the seat. Oh, he caught it.
Welcome to day 5 of the quarantine homeschool situation in the world today. Today is, quote, home economics day, where we're learning all about how to manage a household. So we're doing laundry, vacuuming, cooking. We're gonna have a fun day today. You guys are so lucky. You're exercising too? Oh, you're doing a great job in home ec class, Tom. I could get used to this homeschooling thing. Ending day 5 of a quarantine with a hockey dance party. Even mommy's dancing.
Ah! Mom, you can't dance here. You have to dance.
Heightened states of emergency across the nation as a number of coronavirus cases soars above 3,000. Tonight, elected officials taking unprecedented measures to keep people safe. Illinois and Ohio closing all bars and restaurants beginning tonight. California shutting down bars and wineries and asking those 65 and older to self-isolate.
We recognize around the rest of the world that we need to meet this moment head on.
New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio closing all New York City public schools, affecting more than 1 million students starting tomorrow.
There is a real possibility that
by closing our schools now, we may not have the opportunity to reopen them in this full school year.
Puerto Rico declaring a curfew and closing all non-essential businesses. And more than 40,000 residents in Teaneck, New Jersey, ordered to self-quarantine. During this public health crisis, major retailers are also going dark. Bars and restaurants could be next in New York City.
Every option is on the table. This is a crisis that will be with us, first of all, I believe, at least 6 months.
Meantime, confusion leading to chaos at U.S. airports under the administration's European travel ban. Lines stretching for hours in New York, Dallas, and Chicago's O'Hare. Beth Kander described her 30-hour travel nightmare.
It felt like being in some sort of dystopian novel because we didn't know if we were going to be quarantined or if the 9 hours that we've been in the air, things had become so bad on the ground in the States that they didn't want us to get off the plane for those safety reasons.
They should have increased the Customs and Border Patrol numbers, and they should have increased the number of CDC personnel on the ground doing those checks. They did neither of those.
Kathy joins me now from JFK Airport. Kathy, the acting head of Homeland Security, just said the wait time is now an average of 30 minutes from the White House. What are you hearing?
Well, Kate, we just spoke with several people on the ground here, and because of the extra screening process that is in place here at JFK, the wait time is still a minimum of 2 hours. Kate?
All right, Kathy Park, thank you. NBC medical correspondent Dr. John Torres is with us for the full half hour here, answering crucial questions, also from our viewers, things that people ask us on social media. Let's start with Illinois, Ohio, closing down bars and restaurants, California closing wineries and bars. The White House administration officials just said they'll give us more guidance nationally tomorrow about what to do. Could we be looking at more closures or, you know, a mandate that all bars and restaurants close nationwide?
In that same briefing, Dr. Fauci said everything's on the table. That includes shutting down things nationwide if the numbers start accelerating. So hopefully they're starting to make the movements to get it under control and flatten that curve. If not, you're going to see more shutdowns.
He said even